All right, Harry. For the past seven seasons now, actress Catherine Bell has played a by-the-book military lawyer on the hit CBS drama JAG. This season, her character, Lieutenant Sarah McKenzie, Mac, went undercover as a pregnant woman, a role in which Bell recently had some real-life experience.
Thank you, Colonel, for just getting the both of us killed.
I thought you wanted a Farsi speaker.
I want a Farsi listener.
So I should be seen but not heard. Is that what you want, Webb?
Look, I want you to monitor conversations, not respond. Otherwise, the last sound that you will hear immediately after letting our enemies know you speak Farsi will be a bullet passing through your brain.
Point taken.
They're real?
They ought to be. Drag your pregnant wife through the jungle. It's the least you can do.
Catherine Bell's with us this morning. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And I guess the reason we should say that you have this experience is because...
Because I was pregnant.
Yeah, you have a three-week-old baby.
I have a new little baby, yeah.
How's that going?
It's fantastic. She's so beautiful.
Yeah, is she? And is she sleeping all night?
Some nights, yes. Last night, no.
But you said she did well on the plane, and that's
what's
important.
She did great on the plane. She does great in cars, so if anything goes wrong, we put her in the car seat, we get in the car, we drive around the block, and then she's out.
Oh, I see. You're falling into that new parent
trap.
Yes. Okay, good.
All the tricks.
Hey, I want to talk to you about the series, though. It's been going very well for you.
It's
seven seasons now, and you're a strong female lead in a testosterone-laden series.
Right. I know. It's incredible. It's so unusual, too. Just, that kind of a role on television is so great. When I found out that they were casting that, I had to go after it.
So yeah. Good, strong cast, though, too.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Right. Yeah. What's coming up? I know that you have there's this weird relationship between you and Harm.
Yes.
I mean, is there a...
It's like 8 years already. Shouldn't they just,
Yeah.
Not for the foreplay, no.
Yeah, because, okay, she goes on this mission in the season ender.
Right.
She goes on this mission. It doesn't turn out as it should, right?
Right.
And she ends up going by to say goodbye to him first. So let's take a look at this clip.
There's a story here, somewhere.
Listen, I'm going away.
Where?
Can't say.
For how long?
Don't know.
This has Webb written all over it.
He needed a pregnant wife. I'm his cover story.
Is it dangerous?
Very. I travel to Paraguay tonight.
Oh, come on. What gives here? Give us the skinny. What's going to happen?
I can't tell you. You're going to have to watch.
Well, there seemed to be a note of jealousy there on his part.
Yes, there is. There is some definite jealousy and an interesting... Well, there's just an interesting relationship shift that's going to happen towards the end of the season.
Well, now...
That's all I can say.
Yeah, that's not a tease. I don't know what is. Yeah, all right. Now, you, though, play this very conservative character on TV, and yet you really have done some things of late, some magazine covers that kind of show it all.
Right.
Here you go. Well, there, that'll wake you up for morning television.
Just before I got pregnant.
Yeah.
Wow, look at the difference in those two pictures. That's fine.
Yeah. Why'd you decide to do it?
The FHM. Basically so that people knew that I wasn't just, it's funny, I'd meet people and they go, oh, I thought you were much older and much more conservative. And I was like, well, hang on, there's this other side of me, so I wanted people to see that.
Are we going to see more of those?
Of those covers?
Because we couldn't possibly see more of you, I think there's...
No, I think that was good. Just the one, just that little taste was probably good.
Yeah, I know a lot of people, you say, I don't listen to those people say, your body just goes to pot after 30.
Right, no. No, I don't agree with that.
Are you 30?
Around there.
Yeah. Well, listen, come back and talk to us when you're 35.
Okay.
All right, also, you've got coming up, you did a lot of auditioning in some for some movies, and you landed a big role.
I did. I'm doing
coming up.
I've got a great, great role. I play a newscaster in a Jim Carrey movie called Bruce Almighty, which is coming out next weekend.
What was that like?
Look at him. He is so funny. All my scenes were with him. So he's just incredible. He's so much fun. I had a blast.
I want to talk to you a little bit about your husband, because talking about fun, you guys seem, everything I've read, you seem like a couple of big kids.
We are totally kids.
Yeah?
We're going to have so much fun with our kid, we're going to be fighting over the toys.
Well, is that what attracted you to him?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
He has a huge sense of fun, and we're just big kids. We love to play and try sports and ride motorcycles and just have a good time.
What's he think about being a new dad?
He loves it.
Yeah.
He's so cute.
Who's
so cute
more
to
sleep?
Watch him with a baby?
Him or you?
We alternate. Uh-huh. He's such a sweetheart, so like I'll feed and then I pass her off to him and then he changes and, you know, we alternate sleeping.
Oh, all right.
Perfect.
Well, Catherine Bell, good luck to you.
Thanks
so much for stopping by. And I know, I mean, being a new mom, that sleep deprivation, it's like, that's real tough. So
yeah,
we thank you for
taking a nap this afternoon.
Good idea. Yeah, right. As soon as the baby sleeps, get a
Definitely.
Nap. Thanks. And you can catch JAG tonight at 8, 7 Central right here on CBS. Now here's Julie.